Hello everyone and welcome to this overview of switch port mapping within Lansweeper. Right here we're on our switch page within Lansweeper. As you can see here at the top we have our Cisco switch. It shows the model, also the description, as well as also serial number and some additional information. But the information that we're really looking forward to is here the network information and the interfaces. So as you can see, there's a lot of data here that we retrieve from your switch. Starting with obviously the ports themselves with the numbers, then going over to the names, so the individual names of your ports. If you have an alias assigned to those port names, it will also be displayed. Description, if there is any, the type of port as well. And then next to that, we have our admin status of our ports, whether it's in admin status or not. Then we follow up with the MTU of our port and one very important one, the speed. So if it's either 10 megabits, a gigabit, or even 10 gigabit, if you have a faster network switch. Next to that, we have our IP addresses and also the subnet mask. And then again, another important one is the MAC address, which is the actual MAC address of the switch port. So that's the switch port MAC address. It's not the actual MAC address of the device that is attached to your switch. Next to the MAC addresses, you have the actual assets. So this is the device that is connected to that port. You'll see there's a few uplinks there. Uplinks are displayed when, for example, you have another network device connected to the switch. So if you have a router connected to the switch that has multiple ports on it as well, or you have another switch connected to this switch, when Lansweeper detects a large amount of ports connected to one port, it'll tag it as an uplink instead of showing the actual device name. Below the uplink, you'll see a few actual MAC addresses. This is when Lansweeper has not scanned the asset connected to that port yet. So if we don't have a record of an asset and we can just get the MAC address from the switch itself, we'll just display the MAC address. Then below that, you'll see the actual assets. These are assets that Lansweeper has automatically retrieved from your network and it knows. So it can actually map the assets to the specific port it is hooked up to. So as we scroll down, you'll see the list increasing of different types of devices that we have hooked up to these ports. You'll see everything ranging from Windows to Mac to Linux. We have some NAS equipment hooked up to it. We have a vCenter there as well, a Citrix server, ESXi servers. You know, it's all the different types of devices that Lansweeper scans are automatically hooked up and linked to the port if they're connected to it. And a really nice thing is that these are all hyperlinked. So if I go to, for example, this Sonos here, you get some quick basic information. If we move over to one of the Windows machines, you'll get some more information here about the Windows machine that pops up. So as you can see, it's a really useful tool to get a quick overview of which devices are hooked up to which port, quickly get to their specific information. So what is actually attached to that port? Is it a Windows machine? And what is on that Windows machine? And also you can use all the other information to see, okay, which of my devices are hooked up to a gigabit port or which ones are still running on a 10 megabit port. So now we're gonna take a look at one of the devices to see what we actually retrieve from those devices. So we'll head here over to one of our Windows assets. So as you can see here, we have a lot of detailed information about our Windows asset. We have our OS, our build number, our build version, the manufacturer model. Then we have some more hardware specific information such as memory, processor, motherboard, onboard graphics, antivirus status, as well as some network information. As you can see within the network information, it displays which switch it is connected to. And again, that switch is hyperlinked, so you can quickly see some additional information and you can click on it and go back to the switch overview. On the right hand side, you also see the express code and the serial number, which also means that we can automatically retrieve our warranty information here. And then at the bottom, we also have our automatic relations, which are the monitors that are connected to this specific Windows machine. Again, those are hyperlinked. You can go to their specific page where you'll find the monitor serial number, for example, and some additional information. Okay, so how do we get all this information? It's very simple. All you have to do is, you know, grab Lansweeper, do a IP range scan. The IP range scan will automatically pick up both your Windows machines as well as your switches, other network equipment and other types of devices. It will all be scanned agentless. Once you've finished scanning, you'll end up on the dashboard. So now that we're on the dashboard, we'll head over to the assets tab. And as you can see here, a bunch of different asset types have been scanned and have been retrieved from our network. And obviously we're interested in the switch. So we'll click on switch, and here we have an overview of all the switches that have been detected within our network. And we can go back to the switch that we started on. So now another useful way to go through this data is by using our reports. Now Lansweeper has over 400 built-in reports, and one of those is a switch report. So we'll quickly go over to the switch report. We'll have here we go. We have a switch ports report. So this will display all the ports that you have in your network, and it's organized by actual switch name. So here you can see on the left-hand side, we have our switch that we were just on. The useful thing about this report is that you can start filtering data. So for example, if we just want to see ports that have a 1 gigabit connection, we can easily filter for that. There we go. Now we have a list of all the gigabit ports. And you can do the same for all the other columns here that you can see. If you only want to see specific devices or specific port numbers or ports with a specific description, you know, it's all possible. For example, I want to see all the Dell machines that are linked up to this switch. So just type in Dell here under manufacturer, and it will filter the report automatically on all the Dell devices. So now we have a list of all the Dell devices that are hooked up to a gigabit port on our switch. Now we'll head back to our switch. Again, even in the report, it's hyperlinked. So we'll click on that, go back to our switch page. And now we'll move over to the additional data that we can retrieve with our custom OID scanning. So by default, we pull back a lot of information as you've seen. But the advantage of network equipment is that often it supports SNMP. That's also how we retrieve the data. And the advantage of using SNMP is that there's a lot more data that is kind of specific to your own device, and that can be retrieved with just adding custom OIDs. So you can scan pretty much anything that your network device has to offer. In this case, our switch has to offer by entering OIDs and scanning them. So as you can see here, we have an OID for our iOS version. We have the average CPU usage over the last 5 minutes, the total flash memory and the free flash memory. These are just 4 examples of what you could retrieve. But there's usually on switches, there's other OIDs for things like temperature or data streams and the amount of data that is being processed by the switch. So this is more of a way to get performance data. Now, one last thing we'll take a look at is location. So Lansweeper also includes location maps. This is a feature where you can upload blueprints of your office to kind of map your assets and their actual physical location. So here, for example, we have a blueprint of one of our offices. There's a variation of different devices that we've put here on our map. So you can see our switch here. We also have some Windows machines, an IP phone as well. Again, as you notice, these are all hyperlinked. So I can actually go over to it and take a look at the summary of it. You can do the same for the users that are linked to them. We have a Linux machine here. We have some ESXi machines here, a printer as well, and so on. This way, Lansweeper provides both an overview of your switch ports and how they are mapped, but you can also have an overview of where those machines are physically located. If you need to do any kind of maintenance, or if you have to switch ports or anything like that, it'll be easier to find the actual endpoint or just the switch itself. So this is just a glimpse of what Lansweeper has to offer. There's much more to see. So if you're interested, just head over to lansweeper.com and start your free trial and try it out yourself. Thank you for watching. And if you want to learn more about Lansweeper, you can watch the following videos to help get you started.